everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Rayne, and we're back with another episode of Lost Constellation, which is the second supplement for Night in the Woods. So without further ado, wait, what did I do? Oh, okay, so now I can travel. Okay. So now we're in a new world? Traveller? And who are you? Adina, an astronomer. I seek an audience with the Forest God. I'm sorry, Adina, but the Forest God will not entertain you. Kings, emperors, ones of high import. Only those am I permitted to allow through. But I'm important. I'm an empress? I may wear a blindfold, but I can hear that you are alone. And no empress would travel alone. This is highly improper. This is highly annoying. If you are indeed an empress, bring your entourage here, and we shall discuss the situation. Until then, have a pleasant longest night. Thanks. Alright, let's talk to this guy. Hello there. Ugh, what do you want? Sorry to bother you, but I need your help. Oh crap, I died, didn't I? This is so typical. Listen, by me bringing you here, I think you'll be able to get out of these woods, and do whatever dead people do. Is that something I want? I have no idea. Okay, whatever. Follow my lead. Are we doing this? Sure. Ah, I threw it too high. I still can't hear your companions. Oh, they'll be right along in any minute. So I need to get this guy done. Is there another one I can do? Not. Tonight to wander through the forest some more to try and find something for that person. Hey, a trumpet! My aim has gone too hot in this episode. This is a little bit annoying, not gonna lie. Thank you. this guy is a trumpet player. Imperial advisor, I'm him. And my herald, Harold. Is that a Glundihorn? A what now? Well, what a coincidence. What? Glundihorns hold the curse of eventual death for all those who play them. Really? An extreme misfortune for all who hear them. But you're still alive. The dread curse of the Glundihorn is the ever-present shadow of death. And one day, perhaps tomorrow, perhaps when you are old, it will find you. That's not really a curse in the classic sense. It kills you. How much worse could it be? Were you expecting to live forever before you played the horn? Who knows? Nothing is certain. Someday we must all hear the horn. We must have heard it. We who have heard the horn. God Tender, may we bring our cares and curses to the forest god. We shall share a doom, a horn doom. How can I deny my doom mates? Thank you, God Tender. Allow me. Cross onto the holy mountain. I will do. And this slightly shoddy looking thing. Wait. Yes? I'm truly sorry, but you cannot see the forest god this longest night. Why not? We have already come so far for an audience. The truth is, and you must keep this a secret, but the forest god is sick. They are old and dying, and they cannot see you. It might upset them, and we can't risk that. Dying? How could a god be dying? I do not pretend to know the ways of such things. If only I knew what was happening. We god tenders are asked. A task with caring for the forest god. But this death, we've never seen its like. Not in the 700 years of records kept since Saint Cecil began tending God. Oh no. We thought when the peace came, all would be well. The peace? Centuries of conflict have weakened them. And not long after they became ill. Her? Do you mean the Huncha? Do not say her name here. My heart is broken, my god is dying. I don't know what my life would be without them. I'm sorry, God Tender. There is nothing you can do, Empress. As a representative of the Forest Throne, I say that no power of the Forest God shall bar your way this longest night. As for her, you are at the mercy. the most dangerous creature in the forest. Thank you, Godtender Brown. Go and take a blessing with you. Thank you, I think. Okay. So now we're gonna keep walking. I'm always just gonna go to the right while I'm in this section of the wild because I don't know what else to do. You. Hey, Sticky. What is Sticky? I named you Sticky because of Sticky. The sticks. Sticky. Yep. Why is Sticky? You're infuriating. You really are. Hello. I'm looking for the Hunter. I never found her. And maybe that's a good thing. She's not the forest god. She does not grant passage. She is something altogether more nihilist. Is that the word? She's an impulse playing itself out. She isn't the first and she won't be the last. What? Oh, I don't know, child. I'm just talking. You'll never find her. Hollow without something to help you. And I never found out what it was. Thanks anyway. Be careful, you're getting into something here. Good luck. Okay, I have no hope for the future, I don't think. I think the concept is really fun that, like, you're kind of, the god, the forest god, has power to, like, take you back to where you were before. Skeleton. One of these days he's gonna respond. So like, what I mean is that you keep passing the same things, but not necessarily in the same order. Does this take me to somewhere different? Wandering through the forest until we find something new. Like the cat again or something. Oh, oh, oh! Is that beer? Is that seriously beer? Okay. So we now have some beer. Would you like some beer? Okay. So I can't just take you apart, but are you in pain? You just seem so sad, Sticky. I am nothing. See, I don't know how to interpret that. Like, are you depressed or are you literally saying you are sticks and ice? I am sticks and ice. Yeah, I still got nothing. I'll be back, Sticky. Sticky, be back. That's the spirit, Sticky. Right? Can't tell if that guy lost his mind before or after I turned him into a snowman. Tell me good luck? Yeah, you're still telling me good luck. Huh. Hey! People! Hello! Ho there, traveller! Hi! What is your business here tonight? I'm going to the Frozen Lake. Well, that's a coincidence, so are we. Blessed meeting. Do you know the way through the woods? We surely do. We are bound for an audience with the forest god. And after that, we have an arm and fire to light it. What did you say you were going to set on fire? The arm of a dead criminal. Donated, of course. Oh, Stevenson. And you're going to set it on fire? Yes. And it will light the way to the Hunter's Hollow. Oh, this forest. Well, best of luck. Best of luck to everyone! Even you, we have enough luck to go around. So is this your land? I was just saying because you're a king and all. I may be a king. You may be. But there are kings and there are gods. Yes, yes. Oh. And as king, I granted these lands to the Baroness Lullopsy. And she sure did die. Sure did. Lullopsy Man has gone weird now. Sure has. Last spring, travellers saw this pale thing come out of the bog there and... Well, let's head out. Miles to go, men, miles to go! Beautiful forest, don't you think? Hey! Do I have to find that manor? Well, I need an arm. That's an arm. I'm lucky this skeleton is a criminal. Was. This used to be alive. Now I just need to find the fire to stick it in. Oh god. It's cold. Maybe there's a fire inside that guy's cave. I need this guy. Hello, can I interest you in a... What is that? I need to borrow your stove. Wait, what are you doing? Putting this skeleton arm in your stove? No, you're not. Shh. It is done. That is messed up. You're telling me. Please leave now. Okay. It's getting darker. Like, a lot darker. Like, I can't even see my fire anymore! I think I died. This is a great story now. Oh, you like the spooky stuff, huh? You know I do. I hate the other stuff. Well, the other stuff is important too. Hang in there. Okay, I guess. So I can still get snowballs. That's good to know. However, the things that look like they could possibly be gravestones don't bode so well. Who's that walking on my porch? Hello? Oh girl, it's all over now. And with that, I'm going to leave this episode here, guys. I hope you like what's happening. If you like the episode, please like, comment, or subscribe, or any combination of the three, and I will see you soon. Bye!